get to school about quarter to seven, 10 to seven. Get stuff ready for the day, check my plan book, check my computer, check to make sure that I've kind of got everything, got all my ducks in a row for soccer practice, say hello to fellow teachers, welcome the students, get ready to rock and roll. This semester I have world history, first period, I have religion and the Bible, second period, and I have religion and the Bible, virtual, third period. I teach AP European history, I teach Padea. I'm much of an in-person teacher. I enjoy the relationships with the students, between the students, I like to move around a lot. I like the interaction. I enjoy sort of old school lecture style, but just a give and take between a teacher and a student. Just try to make a subject like history come alive, try to make it interesting, and just hope you're doing your job.
Ezekiel, Jeremiah, the four major prophets. What's their basic theme?
I am grading like quizzes and worksheets and planning practice. And if time allows, working on stuff virtually for Monday and hard copies for Monday.
I have a plan book.
I think we're still supposed to keep these, but I've always been. So it looks like hieroglyphics, something like imperialism 1871 to 1914 is like 15 to 20 minutes of lecture to me, or in the religion, Isaiah 9:6, you know, for unto us a child is born. You know, so they're just triggering points of lecture, points of debate, a quiz we might do, just so that I have a basic kind of fiber of what's going on in the class. Well, all teachers have a day of lunch duty. All teachers have 1 week of morning duty. My lunch duty is on a Thursday. My morning duty week is next week, where I'm in this lobby from 6:55 till the start of first period. We have proctoral assignments for things like ACTs and SATs and EOCs, which can involve a couple of hours or 4 hours, and graduation responsibilities. Obviously, with my wife being the graduation coordinator, I love to see her make a success, but all teachers are supposed to be on duty for that, and it's a really nice ceremony for the seniors. And obviously my duties as a soccer coach, you know, involves about 2 to 3 hours a day, every day of the season. Well, on a practice day, you know, life goes on till about 5 o'clock. On a game day, I will leave, get some lunch, you know, try to prepare for the game, try to get some rest. But from about, you know, 2 o'clock, 2:30 on, there are things to do at home. We have, you know, a dog that needs to be walked and chores that need to be done. Some groceries need to be picked up. I don't really believe, you know, my wife should be doing all of those. She's as busy or busier than I am. So, you know, all teachers have family lives too. And if you have young children, like some teachers, there's really no time off until lights out. But it's a very rewarding job. This is my 41st year teaching. I've enjoyed it. Try to make the best of where we are now. And I don't really dwell on negatives or pessimism. You just try to do the best you can, and put the students first.